Hello again, and welcome to Should Have Turned Left. I'm Ben, Canadianized on the forums, at TheCanadianized on Twitter.
I'm Pete, and I'm Truxio on the forums. Don't have a Twitter or anything like that.
I'm Noah Evans. I do not have a forum handle, and I don't have a Twitter yet.
Should get on that.
Yet?
The forum handle, at least.
Yes.
You should do the forum prior to Twitter.
Yeah. The rules forums are definitely worth getting into.
Yeah.
No.
Anyways, for once, we have three people on the channel again in Mark 3, and two of them are... I'm not playing! Yes!
We're all happy about that, Ben.
All right.
Cheers, buddy.
Cheers. So, what are you playing, Pete?
I am playing Skorne today. 75 points, Xerxes, the Fury of Halak. I just love the giant rhino model. He's still just primed because I really want to do a good job on the paint. With Tiberian, Titan Gladiator, Cyclops Savage, and Cyclops Shaman, since I know Cryx, I'm playing against Cryx, and they brings a lot of the upkeeps. So Shaman for a little upkeep hate. Double Void Spirit, Mortathir's Wellbreaker, full Annihilators, full Pain Giver Beast Handlers, Tycom Standard Bearer, and full Cataphract Incendiary, because Xerxes' feat affects all attack and damage, not just melee. It's kind of nice. Yep. What do you got, Noah?
Well, I brought Sturgis the Corrupted, and I'm operating under the assumption that in Mark III, since Cryx doesn't have the same sort of threat extension, that Sturgis is sort of nerfed by... by keeping what he already... he's buffed by keeping what he already has. So for this list, I just kept my Journeyman League Jacks. So I ran a Reaper, Slayer, and a... And I switched out a Defiler to keep up all of Sturgis' Warjack points.
Gotcha.
And, and then I ran Iacos and a Stalker to advance the point and get into trouble. And then I ran... full unit of Bane Knights. They were going to be my heavy hitters with Tartarus helping them out. And then for jamming and infantry disposal, I had a min unit of Staxes with a Sea Witch and a Captain, and Bile Thralls hanging out behind.
It's weird seeing Syntaxis is no longer AD.
Yeah, it is kind of nice actually.
And so, and the other thing that this list has that's special is it has four Soul Trappers, because a lot of what Sturgi brings is infantry killing. And so in the new, in Mark III, he has Soul Taker instead of his own, his old special rule, so he can now benefit.
Not a Cull Soul or anything like that. So.
And so now he benefits from Soul Trappers for a Focus Star.
He strikes me as a kind of a Focus Hog.
So. Yes, he is. He's a Focus Hog with low focus.
Yeah.
And except for feet turn, because yay feet.
Yes.
Yeah.
Exactly. And so I rounded it out with two War Witches just to help him out with his focus and to get into trouble if they needed to.
So this was one of those weird days where I had no AD at all. So that's always kind of weird for me. I feel kind of always like already jammed up because I had no AD.
So you could see one AD model on the other side of the table too.
Correct. Just his stalker. So I had I had the Annihilators on the top end with the Gladiator and Tibbers. Xerxes right in the center, flanked by the Tycom. And then he's got I've got the full Incendiary all the way to the right, the bottom of the screen. I figured I would just be drifting a bunch of AoEs into his infantry to try to just light some shit on fire.
Do Incendiary have the new high explosive rule, or...?
They do not. They're just straight POW 12, POW 6 blast with continuous fire.
Yeah, continuous fire is pretty solid.
Continuous fire is pretty solid. They're one of those fun units where the back of the card is blank.
Oh, jeez.
That's always a good time. So they're speed 5, their def dropped to 11, they dropped to 5 boxes, which everyone knows and is lamenting. But, so yes, they are... they're wafer thin. They die to a stiff breeze. But if you can light some stuff on fire, they should do the trick. They're 18 points for a full unit, so that's a good heavy beast. So I really wanted to get them on the table to see if they're worth it.
Nice. So I see you're going first, Pete. Yes. Did you win the starting die roll?
No, actually, didn't I lose?
Yes.
Yeah, I lost, and Noah chose side. I don't know if he wanted the wall or the hill. I wasn't sure what was going on there, but I'm always a fan of going first. So,
so why did you, Wayne, choose to go second and pick the side?
I wanted to see what he would do. I thought that if, since I had Ghostly on the knights, that I would be able to sort of react to what he was doing. Because we had the Nailators stacked over in that side. And so...
Yeah, you don't really have any concerns with terrain or anything like that. And, of course, free strikes.
Yeah, so I mean, it makes sense why the Banes are behind the forest. But with Annihilators up there, did that influence how you deployed or anything like that?
Yeah, no. I put the... I really wanted to basically keep the Annihilators jammed with the Staxes. And then they basically the goal is for the Nailators to feed Sturgy.
Yeah, which they did a pretty good job of.
Yeah, no, I wanted four focus.
An additional four with Soul.
Yeah, not what they used to be.
They're really not. I was pretty sad because there was a couple times that a guy was knocked down and I was like, I don't need a tough roll. I was very sad about it. But the Annihilators did exactly what they were supposed to do, which is run up and die. Unfortunately for me, that also means that Sturgis gets a crapload of souls.
Yes.
So that didn't... If the game had gone one more turn, I'm pretty sure I would have been a sad panda because I think Sturgis would have been sitting on something like 12 focus. Or 12 focus.
Oh, good lord. Yeah. So, spoilers, but oh well.
Just a little bit. Yeah, it's not. I mean, that was me checking some blast because... Xerxes has this amazing new spell called Petrify.
Jesus.
So it's a 3-cost range 10, 3-inch AoE at POW 13, but warrior models hit, so not directly hit, are stationary. So that's, that. I mean, just drop that into a bunch of Satixis or something like that, and all of a sudden they're stationary, and now I don't have to care about them at all.
Tag a unit commander with that, and no charge or no press no forward
orders,
order.
No orders, nothing.
Oh, that's terrifying.
So we'll get to...
Does it do damage?
It's PAL 13.
Good lord.
So we'll get to another point on that a little later.
How does a dude petrify people? I thought that was Medusa's thing.
It's just because he's really terrifying. I'm going to go with it's Xerxes 2.
Him or his rhino?
It's a combination of the two. I mean, he is wielding...
He's a cripple.
But he's strapped to a he's strapped to a 2,000-pound beast, and wielding an 8-foot-long chained mace. I mean, it's really or chained tetsubo. So I mean, I don't really know how a chained tetsubo works. But
I don't know either.
And he's got that vicious flag with that moon-shaped little blade on it, which is fun.
Oh, please tell me that's still actually a melee weapon on him.
Oh, absolutely,
sweet.
So he's still got the mount at POW 14. Which still the auto knocks down. He's still got the PAL 15 with brutal charge on the Tetsubo Lamenter, it's called, and then he's got the battle standard, which is a PAL 12. So he's still got three initials in melee. He doesn't get to use them much in this game. Spoilers.
Huge base melee.
Huge base melee.
Your opponent
is tough,
can typically plan for that type of thing.
It's pretty easy to block in a huge base, even though he can trample too.
Yeah, well, he's got trample and bulldoze, right?
He can. What's his nuts? Tibber's Animus is now bulldoze.
Oh,
so
that's
he can
how
give
he
him
gets
he
it.
Can give himself bulldoze for one fury, okay. Which is pretty solid on a huge base. I don't know. I'll have to look up on the forums about how that works with impact attacks. Because impact attacks...
Oh, jeez.
Because he's a huge base, so I don't know if you can bulldoze stuff and then impact attack. We'll have to look that up. I'm sure we'll get plenty of comments
optional?
On that. A bulldoze is optional.
Is optional? Okay, then you're fine.
I'll double check here since
Lord.
I got my tablet
to the
in front
war
of me.
Room.
To the war rooms,
in the meantime, while we're looking that up, I see two soul trappers at the middle of the table. I see one further up. Is the fourth one up there or what?
Well, no. The soul trappers are basically, the idea is to keep each of them flanking Sturgy so that they can move. They're always 10 inches from him because they collect via a 10-inch range, but they can only give via 5 inches. So you want to be able to walk them 5 inches to Sturgy and then give Sturgy whatever their load of souls is. And so I'm keeping a group of soul trappers on either side of Sturgis just to collect as much as possible.
And Bulldoze is indeed a can. It's an optional.
Oh, okay. So, wow, that's actually really, really good with impact attacks.
Yeah. So wording is, when a model with Bulldoze is base to base with an enemy model during its normal movement, it can push that model up to 2 inches directly away from it. A model can be pushed by Bulldoze only once per activation.
Wow, that gets really stupid with impact attacks. Same thing with slams.
So he can.
You can impact attack a model that's 1 inch away from you.
Oh, my God.
Because you advance an inch, trigger Bulldoze, advance 2 more inches, be base to base, and have the 3 inches to do impacts.
Oh.
And
that's heinous. So I got lucky enough here that he moved the Reaper to, that's my measurement right there, he moved the Reaper to within Tibber's ultimate threat range. So with mobility and rush,
and
2 inch reach, he's got a 13 inch threat range on Tibber's. I did, throughout the game, I constantly, until the final turn, spoiler alert, I continually forgot to enrage my beasts.
Well, it's no free charge anymore. So.
It's no free charge anymore, so I guess I maybe in my head I just said, well, if there's no free charge, then why bother? But I had a full unit of them, so why else? You know, so.
Yeah.
But I completely
Fury
forgot
management,
it.
Because it's not limited to whipping one.
It's,
or
yeah.
Something like that.
No, it's star action, remove, replace up to one.
Yeah, because isn't Xerxes still a Fury 5?
He's still Fury 5. But Fury 5 on a huge base is still a fairly big area.
Well, it's a large area, but with only 5 Fury, you definitely want the management in there.
True.
Bane Knights are running sideways.
Yes, they are.
Why are they running sideways?
They're running around Iacos.
Oh, is that what's going on?
Yeah, they're running. Yeah, that black model right next to his right hand is Iacos.
Oh, okay.
So they're just
and
running
then the
around
stalker
Iacos.
That's on him. That's now advancing.
Yeah. Yep. So it moseys up. He the cards for his deployment zone are still on the table. That's why that looks kind of funky.
Yeah, it's all good. And I assume that was a jump.
That was a mosey jump, yes. Yeah. That was a mosey jump.
You didn't know that Iacos is incorporeal?
Oh, God. Oh, God. We don't need an incorporeal lesser.
Yeah, no, that'd be terrifying.
Haley 3 incorporeal shadows are bad enough.
So here I am picking up Fury. This is the top of 2. So I had Ignite on Xerxes because I really wanted to get that bad boy into melee at some point. But it just, it doesn't really work out for me. So lots of threat range checking because, you know, pre-measuring is a thing.
Yes, it is.
How many bat reps have you got up in Mark 3 now?
This one is number 6, I think.
Cool. So I can stop talking about changes to Mark 3.
Yeah.
So
who cares? You
can. My favorite change to Mark 3, because I love Xerxes so much, he gained sprint innate, which is just, I don't have to bring an Arcanon with every list with him, which I had been doing before. So I no longer have to bring an Arcanon because he always has sprint. Why they decided to give a speed 7 mobility caster sprint, I do not know. That's
because he
just
doesn't have a gun and he's a huge base.
Yeah, I suppose.
Well,
but
more because he's a huge base thing, and like we mentioned earlier,
Matt 8, 3
it's
initials.
It's pretty easy to tell where a huge base is going to end up.
Fair enough. They're fairly limited, but I've had games in Mark 2 with Xerxes 2 with having sprint on him and all that he did some major work because he would kill stuff and then move to just jam more stuff that couldn't possibly kill him.
I still think the thought of petrification with if you can trigger sprint is really terrifying.
Yeah, I mean, if you can get in there and kill something, you have 3 initials at Mat 8, all at a minimum power of 12, 14, and 15. So you get in there, you kill something, you petrify something, you run away. I mean, it's just, it's kind of silly.
And people say Scorn sucks.
Well, yes. Well, the other thing is that this is my first game with Scorn in Mark 3. I'm playing here with Xerxes 2.
Oh.
So I have not. This is my very first game with Scorn in Mark 3. So I do take a little more time than I would have liked, but hey, I know that the Stalker and Iacos are still stealth, so I start. And I know that the Lacerators still have magical weapons, so that kind of limits my movement on my void spirits. So I put him up there close to the front with the intention of jamming the Satixis. So I don't, because I don't want them in my face. They're just kind of irritating. But I do have a lot of my army. Like the average mat is 7, so I actually do pretty well with high defense.
Yeah. By the way, while I remember, this matchup brought to you by Lord Rourke, which I'm pretty sure I already screen capped the comment.
Oh, very nice. Is that the one where he requested the Skorne versus?
Yeah, Skorne versus Cryx. And
does he say because they both suck?
Any factions, eh? How about Skorne versus Cryx to unleash all of the misery in one convenient package? Or maybe a revelation of effectiveness.
Right. Okay, so here, right here, my first shot with the incinerators, I lit the Stalker and Iokos on fire.
Oh, God.
Everything else missed. So it was, that was kind of miserable. So.
Yeah. No, that really saved me there because the knights were bunched up.
There was one more. I apologize. That's not completely accurate. I actually landed that boxcar that I just rolled. It was I landed a POW 6 blast damage on Iokos and rolled a boxcar.
Ooh.
So he actually had to reduce that or die. So he took a 1 point from that.
So are you... I assume you're... Oh, no. I guess from some angles you would have line of sight to Iokos, but...
Well, I was shooting at the Stalker.
Okay, yeah.
Oh,
so I figured line of sight would
no,
be easier.
No, actually, I boofed on that because I wasn't the Stalker 3 inches.
No, from the sides he's not.
Okay.
The other guy's like the one that's straight forward. Ahead.
Yep. Yeah, that looks like you probably have less than 3 on that forest.
Well, I'm pretty sure
that template and look.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure some of those guys actually ended up. A lot of those guys shot at knights and it just drifted in the wrong direction.
Yeah. No, but there were 2. That might have been a boof on my part. Oh, well.
Well, I had at least
5 out of 6
that could still see... 4 out of 6 that could still see the Stalker. Yeah. So that was a little...
Every single one of them has a line. Except maybe the guy center back.
Gotcha.
Well, he's one of the guys that tried to drift something into the Knights.
Oh, okay. Everybody else.
So here's some using the 10-inch spray for a hard measure because I want to get some things in range. This is where I used that petrify spell for the first time where I shuffle up.
Yeah.
And I'm trying to tag that Satixis who's a 16 on the hill.
Oh, that still looks like a dirty spot to land it.
It would have been a dirty spot to land it because even though they don't take blast damage because he did the wind thing.
They still get stationary.
They would still be stationary. But actually, I'm pretty okay with where it landed ultimately. Yep. So
the granted force barrier because Satixis has to pick that now.
Right. Yeah. That makes me happy. A lot of the things that they changed was Satixis are still really good. They're just not stupid good.
By the way, it feels like they took advanced deploy away from a lot of things. Satixis lost it. As a circle player, Tharn Ravagers and Druids of Arboros both lost it.
So you can see there's the measure where it hit. It tagged three Biles and Sturgis.
Yep.
Oh, God.
So it's POW 7 blast damage, and everyone under it is stationary. Which I was pretty happy with.
You tagged Sturgis.
I was like, I didn't get the Satixis, but I got Sturgis, so hey, that's cool. Let's see.
We got blast damage rolls, and I'm assuming the one boost was for Sturgis.
Was it? No, it was to hit, and I missed. Pretty sure the one boost the only boost that I did in there was to hit because the casting the spell brought me down to 0 because it's a 3 cost, and I boost to hit.
Oh.
Because I upkept ignite.
Okay.
So I'm on. Xerxes is sitting on empty right now.
Maybe it was a column and I missed something. I don't know.
So there's Tibbers beating the heck out of trying to beat the heck out of the Reaper. At one point there, I did smash a Satixis because I wanted the overtake to just get right up into the Satixis grill. I was pretty confident that even with the Parasite, that the Reaper couldn't take down Tibbers by himself. Because he's even with Parasite, he's still a total armor of 18.
How many boxes?
Lots. I don't know. I didn't
think 32, I believe.
30. Holy crap.
It's over 30. He's a tough
one. Yeah. Over 30 boxes, arm 21. So you're
So I dropped the armor.
Almost better than most Kador Jacks at that point.
Let's see here. Hang on.
Yep.
Does Iacos have Dark Shroud or anything like that? Scything Touch?
No.
No? Okay.
No, that's the new Iacos.
Oh, no.
Right.
Sorry. Let me reset. Yep.
Sturgis does, though. Yes.
Chain Attack, Dark Shroud, which means Sturgis remains up there. And
yeah.
Oh, yeah. Tibbers is armor 21 with 32 boxes.
Oh, good God.
He is a beast.
Yes. Literally. Yes, he is.
Literally. he's pretty solid. But again, this is my first game in Mark III, so I'm pretty pleased with how they performed overall. Drifting a bunch of AoEs, a lot of the Incendiary are about to die in a second here.
Did you ever trigger, or do you trigger Vengeance on the Knights this turn?
No, because I did not kill a single one.
Ah. Lucky you.
I didn't drift a single... Well, I mean, it's Pal 7 Blast against armor. Are there still armor 15 or 16?
No, they're 16. Yeah.
They're 16. So, I mean, okay. The likelihood that I would kill them isn't great, but if I could light them on fire, that would be great.
Yeah, I don't think Vengeance triggers off fire.
I don't think so.
I think it has to actually be an attack, not...
Yeah, I think it says enemy attack.
Yeah, I think it has to be an attack. So.
I don't think fire ever... Welcome to Mark III. We have to double-check everything we used to know just to make sure it still works.
Exactly. So that's end of my two. So you can see we're still kind of just eyeballing each other's ultimate threat ranges going,
Yeah, close quarters is like, hey, you've reached the middle of the table. Guess what's going to happen?
I was actually, you can see a lot, the bulk of my army, you know, basically everything except the Incendiary is lined up to my left. So I was going for his flag the whole game.
Yeah.
It just so happened that he put all of his army on that same side. So
that's a nasty fire roll.
That was the nasty fire roll where he had to spend a focus to reduce. And we had to yell at Ben to confirm that that you no longer remove focus and then check for continuous effects and then refill.
Yep.
That is very unfortunate. It makes my fire plans very sad.
Yeah, it really does. No, fire is nowhere near as powerful as it used to be on a Warcaster.
Nowhere near as dangerous.
Or on a Warcaster, I guess it's the same on a Warlock.
But yeah.
Yeah. I think that's one of the few situations where overboosting the power field is better than transfers.
Right.
I think it's very limited, though, on that one.
Yeah.
Well, I think that overboosting the power field is great on Journeyman Warcasters, too.
Oh, it's definitely great on them.
I actually think that, I mean, well, we all know mathematically that transfers are still better than overboosting.
Yeah, because you get rid of all the damage, so unless your beast is already super hurt, there is no spillback.
Exactly. Where, you know, if I originally thought in my first couple of games, well, my first one game before somebody corrected on me and made me very sad, was that you could only spend one focus to overboost, per attack.
I thought that was the way it worked. Is that not it? You can multiply overboost.
No,
you can only spend one.
You can only spend one.
Yeah,
I thought you could do multiple.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
You have a damage roll coming in that does 16 points of damage. You can only reduce that to 11.
Exactly. So I went the first game I played in Mark III. I was like, well, I'm taking 15 damage. I'll spend 3 and reduce it to 0. And they're like, that's not how it works. And I cried a little. And promptly lost. I think. I'm pretty sure. I've been losing a lot in Mark III.
Yeah.
Because the transition has not been super easy for me. Except that I've been playing Krissa in the recent Journeyman League. And she is kind of like... Like, as soon as Krissa hit the table and I saw her rules and all that, I was like, oh, yeah, I get to play my swordsmen because they're one of my favorite units. Yeah. And, you know, a bunch of Pal 14 weapon masters with continuous fire is kind of hilarious.
That seems cool, but Shredders, oh, good Lord, did they take
it? Oh, Shredders just got murdered. I feel so bad for the poor little Shredders.
Yeah, I'm like, I looked at the Shredders, I looked at what they did to the Harriers and the Stingers and went, well...
Yeah, all the lessers.
Now I don't have to paint the lunch ladies in the pot, and all I have to do is paint the Blighted Bather because I like the model.
Yeah, all the lessers got kind of terrible.
Yeah. Okay, so we are in Noah's turn. Something is attacking something. Tough checks are being made. So, hey, Nihilators.
So, yeah. It's Satixi's okay. Beating up Nihilators right now.
Yeah.
So, you can see Tibbers is on 4. Tibbers has got 4. The Gladiator has 2. And I believe... And I have the one errant dude. Excuse me. The savage that ran up to block tartar sauce and, well, in theory, block tartar sauce because stupid ghostly. block tartar sauce. So block up tartar sauce and that slayer just to you know, say, hey, deal with me.
Yeah. Satixis still have mini feet power swell, right?
They do not.
What?
They lost their mini feet entirely.
Are you? Oh, my God.
They've lost their mini feet entirely. So now the only thing they have is the once per turn, anytime during your activation, you get one of the following abilities. Overtake, the wind, or the other one. What's the other one? What's the third one?
Overtake, wind, and then purposeful charge.
Purposeful charge?
Oh.
Whatever the one that...
Relentless.
Relentless, that's it.
Oh, relentless charge. Okay, yeah. So that's the other thing, is they lost AD
and
Pathfinder.
And which, force barrier.
And force barrier and mini feet power swell. I mean, they just got beat to hell. But with Gang now, being a median cost with Gang
they
with
lost
reach
CMA. Huh.
But Gang, Mad 8s.
Yeah. Okay. That
POW 11s and POW 10s. They still have crit knockdown on both melee weapons.
Yeah.
They're still really good. I mean, Matt 7, they're 14-12s, I believe.
They are 14-12s.
Yeah. Yes.
Assuming you're taking the UA, because I think you still
why wouldn't
have
you?
To.
Yeah.
It's a 13-19 unit.
13-19. I mean, 19 is a one. Yeah, that's like a decent character jack.
Yeah, yeah, it's a decent heavy.
I mean, that's still a lot, but...
Huh. Yeah, you know what? Overtake is interesting with Gang.
So this, I'm really... Oh, yeah, that's right. This was your feat.
Yes, this is
so
me
we're
double-checking.
I'm doing lots of movement because on Noah's turn because it's pulling.
Yeah.
So then he pulls a bunch of stuff in, and then I had to bounce back that Annihilator that I've got my left hand on because he couldn't fit on the far side of the flag. So then he bounces back to his last legal position back on the far side.
Oh, yep, this was another one I got called for.
Yeah, so that saved him. I thought for a second there, I was pretty confident that I had it right, but I wasn't sure if he did Path of Least Disturbance, so he would just move forward and then bounce to the left. But no, it's just back straight back.
Yeah, so Path of Least Disturbance only matters for a model that got slammed or a throw.
Throws, yeah.
Yeah.
So here's where he gets. I think this turn he gets something like 6 or 7 soul tokens. So if Noah had gotten another turn, it would have been pretty ugly for me. Whoa, you all right over there? Was that the chair or you?
No, that was me. That was just me tossing my phone down onto my iPad.
Oh, I thought you were shitting yourself.
What?
Nothing. Never mind.
Oh God.
I thought that just was one of those loud pop type farts or something.
No. We're good.
I'm just watching silly shit on my phone. I think I was scrolling through a Tumblr feed.
All right, so where are we at, Noah? What are you planning? What are you doing?
So the problem here was is that I made a mistake and I didn't allocate to the Reaper. So I more or less had defeat. I was confused with the flames, like my flaming Iacos and Stalker distracted me, and so I forgot to allocate after I powered up. And so I basically had to feed here to get the focus under the Reaper.
Oh, did we mention that you forgot to shake stationary on Sturgis?
Oh, yeah, I forgot to shake stationary on Sturgis, too. We had to take back for that.
I allowed him to take that one back. So.
Yep. And so now this is the Reaper buying attacks against Tiberius.
Tiberion.
There you go. And so I think I got him down to 12, right?
He got me down to 12. So you had 20 total boxes just with the... Was that before or after Parasite? That was after Parasite.
Yeah, it was after Parasite.
So you parasited Tibbers and then got him down, did 20 damage to him total.
Yep.
Not bad.
So there's a mosey and jump from the stalker. I didn't realize that they now have a 1-inch melee.
Yeah, I love stalkers.
That is so good on the stalker.
Yeah,
that's really good.
The walk, jump, 1-inch melee range. So he gets all three of those guys. So I thought I had spaced him out pretty good, but I was wrong.
Yeah, 1-inch melee is surprisingly far.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, and I mean on something that's so mobile too, because I mean they have a walking 13-inch threat range. With Matt 7, Pow 12, Grievous Wounds, they're really good. And I mean, running them with Iacos is a good option because you still have a 16-inch control area.
Yeah, you have a 16-inch control area, and with Escort, their threat range goes up.
That's right. They can walk 9, jump 5, so they're actually a 15-inch threat range.
Yeah.
Walking. Not to mention jump with the new backstrike rules. That's even better.
So now he's just busy murdering a bunch of incendiari. So he actually, on average, he took two attacks per incendiari.
Yeah.
At dice minus 3. So there's my field promote.
Yeah, that's about right.
Yep. Yeah, dice minus 3. He didn't have Pathfinder, but he had a walk and jump with Iacos. So he still gets Iacos in there. And murders that last guy.
There
you go. That was good times. Iacos is kind of a little kind of a dick.
we have his epic form.
Yep. Yeah, he's even a bigger dick now.
I haven't seen any. Who's got the rules for him yet?
I do.
You guys? Oh, is he already in War Room?
He's
already in War Room.
He's really obnoxious because he
I asked about Jake's today, and they're like, no, she sold out in 2 seconds. I was like, that was very sad.
Yeah, no, the store was dead. That day, it took 30 minutes for it to process.
I also thought that people already like crashed in the first few minutes, because the store can never really handle lots of traffic spikes in traffic.
So still has jump, drag, grievous wounds.
Right.
What does he have? Oh, he has a sail. That's interesting.
Yep. Oh, that is interesting.
Carnage, saving touch, stranglehold.
Does anybody else have stranglehold?
What's his?
Lots
feet?
Of people have stranglehold. Actually,
lots of people do now. What's his feet?
His feet, plus three speed and assault.
Yeah.
Oh my god, for what?
For his battle group.
Okay.
Woo.
That's still terrifying. You can just take just spam Reapers.
Well, it's not
just
that
speed
good.
9 Reapers with assault.
Because the problem is the drag succeeds, but the charge fails.
No, I know, I got that. Have we confirmed that they...
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, just the checking. Movement check is done before the assault shot even happens.
I thought that would be the final ruling, but
yeah,
I was hoping.
Okay, why do we have?
What?
I hate spells like this. White Squall. Instead of suffering a normal damage roll and non-cure, blah 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 blah, I'm gonna look up Kruger's Tornado,
and see
if it's the exact same damn thing under a different name.
Yeah.
So this is still Noah's.
Yep.
Turn two?
I'm attacking the Cyclops. Yeah, this is turn two. I wandered Tartarus into backstrike.
Yeah, into the back arc of the Cyclops there, because ghostly is a thing.
Oh, it is different from Tornado. Okay.
Hmm.
Yep.
Two less range, one less pow.
Hmm.
Yeah. And so.
So lots of beating up on the poor little Cyclops. I think he leaves him on 4 boxes.
Yeah, no, that really made me sad.
I knew the Cyclops was gonna die anyway. I put him up there purely to occupy your time.
Yeah, no, I was hoping that I would get him straight on with Tartarus, and then the Slayer could actually do work.
He's still an armor 16 light beast. I mean, he's not awful. And I was actually looking at it now. Unless you can give the path, well, unless you can give if you can give Pathfinder to the Slayer. I would probably my caster might be in melee range, but without Pathfinder, you have no chance.
Well, the other thing is you were blocking, so there was no way that even if it charged, it would have gotten into melee range with your caster.
The Slayer without that water being there.
Yeah.
If you had killed, if you'd used, if you would then use the knights to kill the savage.
Yeah.
Then the Slayer could have charged Xerxes in on empty Fury.
That's scary.
He's a 13-19 now.
Yep.
What?
13-19 with 20-something boxes.
Holy
crap! He's kind of beefy. There's no doubt.
So they made him beefier. They gave him sprint.
So he's a
The hell? 13. Gave him petrification for a spell.
He's a petrify.
Petrify.
He's a 13-19 with 19 boxes.
Good lord!
So he's kind of a beast. Yeah, I have a feeling that I'll be playing him a little more this season. So, more tough rolls, more stuff dying because this was your feat, I believe.
No, this was after the feat. This the feat happened a while ago.
Oh, this is way post-feat. Sorry.
Yeah, and I forget who was killing Nihilators at that point. Oh, no, that may be when...
Oh, is that when Biles. You seduced one?
No, this
is
I seduced
Biles.
One.
That's right. Yeah. No, this is Biles before seduce.
Yeah, so the Bile actually...
Oh, he's got his spray template in hand.
Yeah.
Oh, and he puts it down.
Yeah, no, I think the Bile... Let's see.
No, so, again, I had a... Well, I had three Biles petrified. One died from blast.
Yeah.
So then he has two out of the unit still petrified.
Yep. There goes the... Still that's stationary. The witch, I think. That's where the witch is possessing. Yeah, no. Gotcha. This is where we're doing a rules check on seduction.
Ah, yes. I was curious about what the actual wording of seduction was.
Yeah, it's kind of broken as
well. Well, it doesn't... It's no attack, no checks, no nothing. Happens. It just happens. Yeah, so that made me sad.
It's like, oh, you're within 7 inches of her. Screwed.
Yeah, yep. my Nihilators,
it's
I mean...
dirty.
You would think they would love pain more than, chicks. But, yeah. It is what it is.
Yeah, how does that...
Whatever.
Yeah.
Because seduction is warrior model, right?
It's warrior model. Yeah.
So she could seduce a mannequin,
technically,
which is a construct.
Yes. Yeah, yeah.
She could seduce an immortal.
It's magic.
That seems weird.
Magic.
Magic. Yeah. Weird.
Oh, here's a question. Can she seduce incorporeal? I think
she could seduce convergence.
Yeah. She can seduce any warrior model.
Yep. Wow.
So, yeah, that's something to think about.
One more shenanigan thing for Gallows Groves that can happen to him for no apparent reason.
But they can't advance or attack.
Or attack.
Yep.
So
wait. We should pause for a second because here comes my MVP.
What?
That. So here I am, drooling, chomping at the bit, like, oh, Xerxes is gonna kill so much stuff, and then he just sticks a friggin' bone jack in base to base with him. Like, oh man, I don't really have anything except Xerxes to kill that freaking bone jack. So I was pretty sad about that. Honestly,
that centered
when it came down to it,
get him out of the way.
Yep.
Well, the thing is that a couple of turns ago, my turn two, when Tibbers got up into combat, he was supposed to kill one more Satixes, which would have moved him in and to engage the bone jack. The bone chicken.
Oh.
So, but I missed.
Yeah.
So I needed a 7. I missed.
Yeah, that's going to happen.
I was going to engage the bone chicken, but I failed. I was very sad. So then the bone chicken engages Xerxes, and Xerxes just sits there like a chump. But his feet is, his control area becomes the table. So at that point, I was like, in that case, I don't really care.
Yeah, pretty much. Also, holy clock disparity, Batman.
Yes. I was moving fairly quickly because I had a much lower model count as part of it. I've already clocked myself, twice on your channel? Once or twice.
The first several games went to clock,
at
I know
least,
that much.
At least one.
It took us a while before we started getting assassinations.
At least one,
scenario.
maybe two. I think it's twice that I've clocked myself on your channel. This is a... I don't remember what this is.
This is Tibbers doing really badly, I think.
Was that Tibbers' frenzy?
Yeah, Tibbers, that was Tibbers' frenzy.
So my turn three, Tibbers at threshold 10 with one fury on him. So I needed 9 or less, and I rolled an 11.
Oh.
So that's, you know how it goes.
Yep.
So he smashed the Reaper in the face, but still didn't cripple anything.
Yes. No, the Reaper, this was the one of the few times where the bad Cryx boxes didn't hurt anything.
Yeah. So the Reaper is down to 6 boxes, but is fully operational.
And no more auto boosted damage on.
Right? Yeah. No, it's just a straight charge attack. I was really hoping for a crit slam because that would have slammed him probably over Sturgis, which would have been hilarious.
Yeah.
So this is me using the one time that I used a proxy base to make sure that I could either trample and or charge the Titan Gladiator. Into Sturgis this turn.
On a different note, I'm still a little sad about, I think, the oversimplification of frenzy rules. And yeah, Mark II Frenzy was complicated,
right,
but
it was.
It's like if you learn the progression, it made sense.
Right. No, I agree. And I think
there's just jank that I can cause to happen with
right.
new rules.
Yeah, no, I agree. One thing that I probably did wrong with that Frenzy. So this is just a little mosey and feat from Xerxes, and
I think that was a Snake Eyes or something.
I think I almost killed the Bone Jack with Xerxes.
I think you may have killed him all the way, and then
did I?
Yeah, you know you killed.
Oh, you know what I forgot?
Yeah. The sprint.
That's a heck of a damage.
No, well I forgot the sprint. Yeah. But what I forgot was that I attacked with the mount first, and the mount auto knocks down. So I kept rolling to hit when I didn't need to. Everything else auto hit. So no, that made me sad. Or post game makes me sad.
Yeah. Well, there it goes. There goes the MVP.
Yeah.
Rule one, read the fucking cards.
Read your fucking cards, yeah.
Rule two,
read your fucking cards. Rule three, read your opponent's fucking cards. Yeah, no. What else did I do wrong? So this is something that I will have to fix next time. Ben can clarify this for me.
What?
So Tibber's frenzied.
Yep.
The closest enemy model.
Closest model.
Closest model period?
Period.
Okay, cool. I did it right then. Closest model period was the Reaper, which is what I attacked. I just wasn't sure now if I had to randomize.
Closest model in line of sight.
In LOS. Okay. So no, I did it correctly because the closest model to Tibbers at the time of Frenzy was indeed the Reaper. I might have just murdered a poor Satixis, but no, it didn't really matter because I didn't kill the Reaper. I ended up not needing to. I just needed to kill some stuff that was kind of in the way.
Yeah.
So I did a fair bit of housekeeping. Got the Nihilators out of the way.
There's a lot of Bane Knights right there.
There's a lot of Bane Knights. If this doesn't work, I am.
Oh, good lord.
If this does
you
not work,
screwed
I am
if you
toast.
Take it.
So the one thing I
did
do...
Did Petrification or Petrify ever go out? Because you could screw a bunch of them up with that.
I camped this round. Case I died, or in case I failed, I camped a bunch.
Petrify is
so
three?
It's three.
And did you pre-measure an AoE just out of curiosity?
Yeah, you can pre-measure anything, right?
Well, no, I'm just wondering... Did you? Because that would be one of those, okay, if you can tag four Banes, that is worth casting a three-cost spell.
Oh, no. I get that. Especially if they're the ones in front or something. You know?
Yeah.
So what it came down to was I decided to camp because I was pretty confident that a Gladiator under Enrage and Hand of Ancients could kill his caster. So, you know, POW 18 with a additional die on attack and damage drop, die of your choice.
Yeah.
Pretty solid.
I like that.
So I'm rolling
because that means you can take the high die away from your own guys if necessary.
Exactly. So I'm rolling lots of dice this turn because I'm under Xerxes' feet. So one of the incinerators walked up and gacked Iokos. I think the standard bearer actually took out a system. took out a system on the stalker.
Yep, got its movement.
Yeah, got its movement out. Killed a couple. So I killed two knights that turn. So I'm giving the other two, four, six, seven, eight, the other eight vengeance. So I mean,
God, oh no.
Yeah. So walking up my Pengiver beast handlers to try to get some dudes into melee, I really only got one. There was one directly behind Tibbers that I completely forgot about until, like, way too late. So I killed one more. So now there's only seven Bane Knights left and Tartar Sauce.
And Vengeance.
And then there's the only thing that I have in the way is that I have a corporeal Void Spirit standing base-to-base with Tartar Sauce, kind of in his charge lane. So he could still walk
solid.
Around him and probably still get into melee, but he couldn't charge into Xerxes.
You know what? That's not a bad plan.
Right.
But still,
by the way,
God, talk about dick in the wind.
Yeah. But seriously, Void Spirits in Mark 3, kind of fantastic. So Yeah, kind of great, because now they always get boosted attack and damage against living models.
Helpful against the undead army.
Super helpful here. Quiet you. So one of them killed Asatixis, and then got to teleport into like Sturgis' back arc. So he's just kind of like, I'm in your way, haha. So that was fun. But I dig them now because they run up whatever they kill, they teleport. They're not mat 7 anymore. They're mat 6 now, which sucks. But they get boosted attack against living models.
Yeah, I would take a 1 mat drop for boosted attacks.
Right? Yeah, it works out.
Yeah.
So here once again, I'm going. Hey, here's my proxy base.
Ooh, what do we get?
An assassination?
Voicemail?
Yeah,
voicemail. So here's where I drop the proxy token, and I'm checking melee ranges, so I know that I can charge a Titan Gladiator into melee with Sturgis, and I boost because I know he's got does he still have reversal?
Yes, he has reversal.
Oh God!
So
yeah, I was hoping for a miss there.
I was needing nines to hit.
You know, at least but he I figured have with auto knockdown.
Exactly. I was going, I need nines to hit. I'm under SMP. I still better boost.
Yeah, you still boost.
So I hit with the charge attack. It's dice. I'm at power. People says 18, so it's dice plus 2. He reduces the first hit by 5. And I think that was the final roll. Yep.
Yep.
So. Oh no, it wasn't. So
instead of
that's right, he had one left. So so what I did, because I needed nines to hit even under SMP, I charged for 1. He's still Fury 4, so I charged and boosted all 3 initial attacks, all at dice plus 2.
Okay, so here are the odds on a 9 plus with signs of importance. So just an 8, 52.3% with 2d6. With 3d6, it's an 89.5. Yeah, you boost that on a reversal.
Yeah, you boost that on reversal.
For sure. So.
Yeah. No, it was solid.
Yeah. Okay, so...
Sturgis had a few tricks that I did not see coming. I think Cryx is still pretty solid, even though my last couple of games against Cryx, I did kind of mullet him. Not this one. You could have had this one. If I had failed that, I'd have been dead.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I really made a big mistake here, and that was not realizing that your guy how the death bonuses were on Tiberius.
Oh, because, you mean the in on the hill in melee? Yeah,
because what I screwed up there is if I had allocated, I would have walked Sturgy into melee, then the parasite would have been an auto.
Just pouring beer.
Oh.
Yeah. And then the parasite would have been an auto hit, more or less.
Right.
And then Sturgy could have teleported out.
Right.
And so
Chain attack, Dark Shroud, minus 5.
Yeah, what was that? Against 20? Well, okay, so minus 5.
No, he's too
20.
Far forward to annihilators for that.
Yeah, you still would have been dead.
Yeah, no, because...
No, even with the extra minus 2 armor for Dark Shroud... If Tibbers had survived, I think he would have been on like 6 boxes instead of 12. In theory.
6 boxes, and that's not counting the damage that Sturgis would have done.
That's what I was just thinking of. He would have taken 6 more under Dark Shroud. And then depending on how much damage Sturgy did, he might have been dead.
Well, so Sturgy would have been dead.
Considering
Tibbers
frenzied, it kind of is a moot point.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Like that would still be way too far forward for Sturgis.
If Sturgy had done that and tried to like spend all of his focus to try to kill Tibbers and failed, frenzies,
that would have been
I'm gonna take the Satixis and put it base to base. Frenzy that.
Exactly. That's the thing. Yep. That is one thing. Is it's pretty easy to jink the frenzy right now.
It really
so
is.
So it's you just put something base to base with the model that may frenzy, and then you're safe.
Or you put something in the back arc that can take a free strike, and then something far enough away that the frenzying model has to advance, and you get a free strike for some stupid reason because oversimplification of frenzy rules. Pretty much.
Yeah.
It's funny with Satixis with crit knockdown though.
Yeah, yeah. Because somebody can, yeah, you can drop them into your back arc and then crit knock them down. Yeah.
That well, being said, it's really lucky. Hard to do.
Yeah.
Well, okay, so it wouldn't, for Tibbies, it doesn't matter. But
no, for Tibbies, well, yeah, it doesn't matter. True, you're screwed. He can't be knocked out. He's coming at you.
That's fair.
Yeah. Well, the one thing that's nice and who never got into the action at all is the Saxis Captain.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
because yeah. She has two auto knockdowns.
That's right. She's auto not
knockdown
crit.
On both. She's yeah. not crit.
Yeah, ooh. She's just yeah. auto knockdown.
Ooh, that's dirty.
So my yeah. original petrified target was the middle of the Satixis. Yeah. I yeah. rolled a 9 to hit. I rolled a 4-4-1. If I'd rolled an 11, it would have frozen like 4 or 5 Satixis, including the captain.
Yep. Ooh.
But yeah. again, I put Tibbers right in the middle of that whole Satixis mess, and I knew he couldn't be knocked down, so I wasn't that worried.
Yeah, and with the loss of Power Swell, Tibbers is pretty safe there.
Yeah, even with Gangi's dice minus 10s and 11s.
Whee!
Yeah, so it's pretty rough on the Satixis. Besides that, he was all up in their grill, so they couldn't get distance to get charge,
exactly.
the charge damage. So it was a solid game all around.
That's gross. All right, so your first game with Skorne. First impression?
My first impression of Skorne is that they do not suck nearly as bad as people say they do.
Damn straight.
I honestly think that the traditional power casters from Skorne are not so powerful anymore, but they still have plenty of tricks up their sleeves. And I know that the number one gripe about Mark III is the loss of the +2 strength and the free charge on the Pain Givers.
Yep.
And a lot of their beasts were reduced to Fury 3. They still do plenty of damage. Before, it was almost overkill. Now, they still do plenty. I mean, I had to max out a Titan Gladiator with a rushed Titan Gladiator under Enrage, still killed a Warcaster. You can't yeah. complain about that.
No, you really can't. All right. And you mentioned your thought with Sturgis was... because his feet stayed the same, you could help increase Cryx's threat ranges.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And since I switched from Agathea to Sturgis,
yeah,
it's my life has been much better.
Really? Sturgis' yeah. feet better than Blink? Or whatever Agathea's
well,
thing
Agathea's
is?
Agathea's feet is awesome.
Vanish.
If you have yeah, a lot one. If you have a lot of things like Satixis, which have long threat ranges anyway.
Mm. Okay.
But the problem I have is that basically Aggie can't handle a counterattack. And
no.
So I always get an alpha, and the Reaper either does or doesn't drag something. And I will kill one Jack, and then when the Vengeance comes from the other Jack that I didn't kill and didn't even knock out any systems on, both the Reaper and the Slayer go bye-bye.
Right.
And then yeah. Agathea either has to do something or die.
Yep. She has Dark Shroud?
Yeah. yeah. Well, I mean, no, she's good as a Dark Shroud applicator.
She is one of the few counters to the combination of Spell Ward Admonition.
Right.
Yes, that is true.
Yeah, they put that in a battle box. That is, good lord. Anybody who says the Circle Battle Box sucks, I don't understand you.
Yeah,
no,
you're,
at all,
you don't
whatsoever.
Make any sense.
That pure blood is ridiculous.
Tanith is goddamn, yeah. is a goddamn monster, by the way.
Yes, watch Wargamer Girl number 26. Watch what happens to an Armor 23 Jack. It's hilarious. I broke her system.
Oh, it's so terrible. Poor, poor Miranda.
But so, on that thought, increasing threat ranges, Iokos, he's +3 speed on his feet for battle group.
Right. And so with Iokos, it's weird. Because the new Iokos, I think, is a really great caster. But he's not what you think he is.
He's still Fury. Yeah. He's still Fury Focus. He's still Focus 6 and wants to run a bunch of jacks because his feet only affects battle group.
Right.
But you have Sirens and you have power up.
Well, you have Sirens with power up.
That being said, Sirens still do the allocate or do the gain focus
thing. They
do a thing,
gain.
Right?
Yeah, it's a gain.
Yeah, allocation is specifically defined now as what the warlock or warcaster does. So.
Yeah, no, it's still a gain.
Yeah.
So they can still get power up and one from the witches.
Yeah.
So I mean, I he's going to be solid, and I know that I thought that I was going to see more jacks today. Honestly, when it comes to Cryx, Well, Cryx is still an infantry-heavy faction, I think. But just in general, playing against War Machine, I expect to see more jacks than I had seen previously. Because I know, as a part-time Signar player, I've been putting a crap load of jacks on the table with Nemo 2 and Haley 2 and all that. Yeah. So, I mean, lots of jacks.
Well,
and
also, how many Cryx lists were, okay, how many jack points do I have, and what is the bare minimum?
Exactly. That's been the rule forever.
Yeah, which, by the way, I find hilarious. That's how you built your list this time anyways.
It is. That is true.
What is Sturgis minimum jack points? Full. Okay.
Yeah. Yep. I did not see that coming. I also didn't see Sturgis coming. I'll admit that.
Yeah, that's pretty funny when that came up.
Yeah, he's, who are you playing today? Oh, I got Xerxes too. Who are you playing? Sturgis, what? Yep.
Yeah. Well, he really is underrated.
I actually can see his appeal, particularly against, against infantry and against as a threat extender. I can see that, absolutely.
And it's kind of one of those, like, what is it? Gorton's got the 5-inch slide feet on a smaller control range.
Yeah. He's a 5 with a 5-inch slide.
Yeah, he's a 5 with smaller control range. When you have a 3 with a larger control range, you still have that option of, oh, you have these key models up front. I'm going to pull them just this much further towards me so I can attack them and
see
the rest of your army's still back there.
One of the things that I unintentionally kind of cock-blocked Noah on was bringing a Battle Engine Warcaster. So he cannot drag my Warcaster in. So I brought Tibbers and Xerxes, which you can't drag either one. So it's just a ha-ha.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. Cannot drag. I have to double-check battle engines to see if they can be pushed. You can still place battle engines. I'm not sure about the pushing thing. Yeah. Drag just... The rule drag specifies you can't drag a larger base.
Can you throw a battle engine?
No.
No. They cannot be...
I thought.
Damn it, Mark III!
Damn it, Mark III! No, the whole thing is that I think in theory, the only thing you could throw a battle engine with is a Colossal.
Right, but well, the thing
so
is
a Colossal.
No,
would,
you can. No, you can't throw larger models. Never mind.
I was gonna say
you can slam them.
No, oh no, yeah, because you can't throw larger bases. Period. Right.
Battle engine 78. Correct.
Yeah.
Okay, battle engines, massive, cannot be pushed, knocked down, or made stationary, cannot be moved by a slam or throw.
Okay, cannot be moved. Okay.
Cannot be moved by, so they still take damage from slam or throw, but they can't be pushed,
they can't be moved, and they can't be knocked down, so.
Yeah.
Yep. Well, I assume that battle engines can't be knocked down. That'd be hilarious.
Yeah.
The
God.
Rhino just flop.
Yep.
And doubly broken legs. Screw you, Xerxes.
And now Xerxes' legs are crushed under the falling rhino.
First Rhett crushes him, and then the rhino.
Right.
And,
yeah,
oh, God knows
he's already got the broken back. Now he's got shattered legs.
Poor fella.
I enjoyed the game. I didn't need the shaman as much as I thought I would. I was expecting crap like crippling grasp and stuff like that. So that's why I brought the shaman.
Yeah, you thought you were going to be taking off upkeeps.
Right. Yeah. Well, I mean, Parasite is a legit upkeep to get rid of.
Yes, it is.
If
for nothing else than to take the armor buff off the caster.
True.
Oh, yeah.
Did you take that into account?
No, I didn't take it into account.
You know what? In the end, it didn't matter.
It didn't matter in the end, but yeah.
Because on my final attack roll, it
was way too much, yeah.
So, in theory, it technically, at the end of the game, instead of being at 1, he would have been at 3.
Yeah.
So, he still died. So, we...
Yeah.
So, yes, we did miss that. Yeah. And, well, you missed that.
Yeah, well,
okay,
both
we
of
missed
you,
that. But we missed that.
I was not playing that game. I'm out of it. I was playing a different game, so constantly repeating, read the card.
No, we only heard that like 17 times, that game. Anyway.
Yeah.
So, yes, Sturgis should have been at like maybe 4. No, 3. Yeah. No, he would have been at 3.
Yeah.
Yeah, because he got hit by the big guy 3 times. He was at 1. Reduce each of those by 1. You're at 3.
Yeah.
So he would have been at 3, but my final attack did enough that would have killed him anyway. So, oops, but it didn't. Kind of didn't matter. Yeah. It could have mattered. It could have.
Yes, it could have. That's
yeah.
Yeah.
So we'll know that next time.
On that note, Sure, it's only one game with the list, but are there any potential changes you do see, or are you pretty happy with how the list performed now, or would you need to play it more to figure that out?
You know, I actually liked my Xerxes 2 list. Even if I wasn't playing against Cryx, I would probably still keep the Shaman, because there's still plenty of upkeep, nasty upkeeps out there, and he can still spam the rush and things like that. He can't cast Tibbers, which would be fun. Tibbers' animus is now Bulldoze, but he can't throw around Bulldoze, because that would be dirty.
Thank God that one's always been self, though.
Right. The only thing Another treasure. hidden things. So the only other thing that I can think is I actually didn't have much use for the Mortithurge Willbreaker, because Feat Turn is SMP, and he gives rerolls. So I did put SMP on the Gladiator before I did the charge. So in theory, I could have used that, but honestly, with SMP up, I didn't need it.
Does Willbreaker still have Puppet Master?
He does still have Puppet Master, but he lost Ancillary Attack, as many things did.
Was it him and the Vassals? Because Assyria keeps it, because she doesn't have an attack otherwise.
I actually think I would honestly rethink the Incendiary and think about putting in the Kel'Tari. They're 3 points less, so then I could also take the other solo.
Kel'Tari are still Cataphract, right?
They're still Cataphract. Or no. They're
Praetorians. Oh, no, never mind.
They're Praetorians. Then I could take the Soul Ward. So on that off chance that I need to give, you know, Tibbers Eyeless Sight and Magical Weapon to have him charge through a forest or hit something that's incorporeal.
Does he have Pathfinder? Relentless?
No, it's Rush gives him Pathfinder. Rush.
Oh, there you go. Yeah.
Rush gives plus two movement Pathfinder.
That's right. That's in faction.
Yeah. So if I drop the Incendiary, add Kel'Tari, which are a pure jamming unit.
Yeah.
Because they're def 15 against shooting. They're 13-13s with reach. They always have reform and ignore free strikes. So they're just like the kings of jamming. They're pretty great
that's
at
pretty
that.
Solid.
So if I had to make a change, the Incendiary, they lit the Iokos on fire. Mm-hmm. But because they don't drop focus prior to they don't drop focus period. It's not as effective as I thought it would be. So the Kel'Tari, it's something I might try. I'm not 100% on it. The Incendiary is still good.
How about you, Noah?
I think I really like this list. I think I would have swapped out the Jacks if I had had more Jacks ready.
Fair enough.
I think
One thing I wonder about, 4 soul trappers, too much?
No.
Not enough?
No, not enough.
Not enough.
Not enough?
Yeah. No,
really?
No.
But you know what? I think you needed to spread them out a little more.
Yeah. Well, the thing is, they actually did their job. Sturgis was like, he was Cartman level fat on souls.
how many souls was he sitting on? 6?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
So he was sitting on 6 souls when I killed him. So if he had survived... Bad things.
Yeah, so that's the weird thing about Sturgis, is that Sturgis does all of his work early, so he goes in, slaughters massive amounts of infantry, and the soul trappers grab all of the souls that he missed, because he only catches on the left. He only grabs...
Oh, that's right,
that's
yeah.
Right. That's his weird thing.
Yeah.
And so the thing is, now all the overflow of souls from his feet, so the feet not only turns dead infantry into focus... But it also turns them into souls.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, good point.
And so the soul trappers...
So the soul trappers can fill up really quickly on that one.
And again, they did.
Yeah.
So you would want the multiples so when one fills up, the next one starts.
Yeah. So I think that only happened on your right flank, though, was the forward soul taker on feet turn filled up immediately.
Yes.
And then souls started overflowing to the one behind him.
Yeah.
And then to the ones on your left side.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was monstrous. He had a bunch of souls, no doubt. So, but again, I was worried/not worried because if he gets all those souls, I'm dead meat. But I'm
well.
I was
if he gets all those souls, the Bane Knights might kill you anyways.
Exactly. Yeah, that too. That's the other thing.
Yeah.
From the distance I was from Sturgis to Xerxes, you would have had a tough time getting in there.
Well, yeah. I don't think that what Sturgis...
Mostly because Tibbers was still in the way.
Right. No, Sturgis himself, I think people think that Sturgis is an assassination canister, but he's not.
He's not.
Yeah, no, he's a support. Not. He's right. support. Yeah.
And
yeah.
So what Sturgis does is he goes and slaughters all the jam, sucks right. up all these souls, and then the next turnaround, he basically makes his jacks as fat as he was.
Yeah, no, running the unit of Biles right in a little U behind yeah. Sturgis... is a hell of a plan, because he walks up and then the Biles walk up and go and they purge everywhere, and then all the soul trappers are full, and yep. next round he's just a monster. So
yeah,
I got lucky with the stationary on the Biles. That was massive. There yeah. was late game, there was one Bile on your right flank, on the your extreme right flank, that I thought should have purged, because yeah. You could have got, or at least shot,
yeah,
because they can still shoot. They're like yeah. rat three,
rat crap.
So you need like tens to hit,
yeah.
But whether you just shoot at them because you can,
yeah,
is just hope.
Why not?
Just hope,
yeah.
Or purge, and you would have killed like maybe one more annihilator. But I mean, it's just something to think about.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Always shoot whatever you have the opportunity to. Yep. Although I know you were getting down on time, so.
Yeah.
That was the biggest time disparity I had seen in one of my games. Anyway, I'm yeah. always the one that's way down on time. Always.
Been a while so. Since I've seen that much of a disparity, but that one can get chalked down to player experience.
Yeah. I mean, I've been
so.
I still lose a lot, and I started. I started playing Rhett during the Mark II beta. So yeah. before Mark II was actually official, I started buying Retribution.
Well, I mean, and not just that, but you have a lot more experience playing on the clock than Noah does. Yeah. This is Noah's first game on the clock.
I've yeah. both played on Death Clock and run Death Clock tournaments and all that stuff. Yeah. So I have played a lot on the clock. So we'll chalk it up to multiple things.
Yeah, I mean... That being said, you being new to the clock,
yeah.
Yeah, there was a huge disparity, but with that, it didn't seem like the clock really got to you at all.
No, I think
so.
I think I basically knew what I wanted to do. I think that
I don't think that yeah. with the casters we were playing, the clock was ever going to be an issue.
yeah,
pretty much. Sounds about right.
Yep,
sounds about right. Both armies. Not a lot of guns. The guns that do exist are short range. So, yeah that was going to be in the middle anyways.
I actually, as Skorne, brought more guns than the Cryx player.
That's not uncommon.
That's not that uncommon, I guess.
Wait. Did you? Because Biles.
Yeah.
How many in a Bile unit?
Six.
Six.
Six
Biles, Reaper, Iacos.
Yeah.
That's eight.
I don't want to count right now.
Yeah.
Screw you guys. I did yeah. not have a lot of guns.
Neither yeah. did Cryx.
The total yeah. number not of guns surprising. On the table on either side was within two, I think.
Yeah.
yeah.
So, no, there was not a lot of guns. I wasn't worried. You don't worry about guns with Xerxes because he's armor 19, so there's not a lot yeah, of high exactly. enough powered guns out there. I might try to find room for a Kriya. But Kriya's only had defense now. They just add.
Yeah, it's
they just add
force
barrier.
So arm 19 immune to blast damage. Wait,
15-19 is solid.
Yeah, 15. Yeah, 15 versus range is pretty solid.
Yeah, 15-19 is pretty solid. But he Xerxes lost his bond, so he doesn't get to cast Animi for free.
No, nope.
But
he has an auto bonded Arcanon without
for free.
It.
So that's more than worth it.
Yeah.
Thank you, Privateer Press. I appreciate that very much. I really do.
Not going to lie, I'm amused that I have a Skorne win on here now.
You have a what?
A Skorne win.
Yes. Yeah. There. Yeah. No, I'm pretty pleased.
Yep.
I'm pretty pleased with Skorne. I'm not saying that I'm not going to stop playing Legion and Signar, because those are the two factions that I've been playing in Mark III. Skorne, they always have a place in my heart.
Yeah,
I love them.
Yeah. Oh, with any luck, I can get a different Skorne player on here at some point too. So I think it's one of those I can legitimately get access to any faction.
Yeah, no, that's the... But people that would actually show up with Skorne, good luck. However,
and it would have to be another Saturday.
Right. So. If people have particular Skorne lists that they want to see played, let me know, because I have most Skorne models. So I can try to accommodate that.
Yep.
But also keep in mind that I am a crazy aggressive playstyle. One of the reasons that I like Skorne is that they murder themselves to win. So, I don't care if I'm down to one model. I'll still try to win the game.
Yeah, speaking of that, I have three circle lists I have to figure out. Two of them with warlocks I'm not a huge fan of, but I'll do it anyways.
I don't have great success
with Chromac 2, and I've got Kaya 2 and Kaya 1.
Are you getting requests to play those, or are you just... Oh, really?
Yeah, somebody actually found me on Facebook and started messaging me.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Ah, welcome to being internet famous.
This is fame?
Internet popular.
We'll go
with popular.
Sure, why all not?
Right. We'll go with popular. any other comments, Noah? What do you think about... What did you think about the game overall?
I thought it was a lot of fun. I wasn't sure. I was actually really worried that you would bring Zol.
Ah. Oh, because, Zol has his...
Oh, that would have screwed Surgeon's
soul. Yeah, his soul mechanics.
So yeah, because the entire list that I brought is all about souls. Right. And so you actually brought the perfect list for it.
Right. I brought a bunch of meat that doesn't do soul stuff.
I mean, there you go. It's a good test for your list.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I putting an armor 23 jack in front of a unit with affliction. Like 20 shots.
Oh,
yeah. I'm sorry. I find that hilarious, Ed. What? Yes, I'm totally derailing from yours, but I'm still amused at the comments that she had to put during that roll sequence.
Sorry, what happened?
So
you put affliction on an armor 23 jack?
Yeah, and then shot it 18 times with Reeves.
That is amazing.
Yes, and since they needed snake eyes to hit, the minus two defense... four attacks would have missed without the minus two death. It was six attacks would have missed without the minus two death. So,
right.
Yeah, 18 hits at dice minus 15. So it was just hit column, hit column, hit column, hit column. 18 times on her video, that the way she records things.
You're a rat bastard. Her system. I mean, that's amazing. I think that's hilarious to do that to her, that poor girl. With all of her... I mean...
Oh, both Wargamer Girl, and Tommy, she just had to take a little minute of going, wait, how are we going to do this?
Yeah, she does amazing editing with all the individual zoom ins on the dice rolls, but I can see where that would be heinous.
Yeah, especially with the new system.
Hyenous.
That they want to record you marking damage instead of creating hard assets for everything.
Oh, my goodness.
So once I got a flick shot there and activated the reuse, it was immediately. How do you guys want to do this? Because I think I just broke it.
It's dice roll, card mark. Dice roll, card mark. Dice roll, card mark. Dice
roll. No, it was just, okay, fine. Record all technically 36 dice rolls, 18 hits, 18 columns, and then just show the card at the end of it.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
You're a bastard.
And it's 18, not 20, because one couldn't get line of sight.
What were you shooting at?
One of the clam jacks.
Oh, okay. I could see where they get to armor 23 pretty easy.
Yeah, exactly. Dice minus 15. I'm like, I don't care. I'm doing 1 point.
What caster was she playing?
Kozlov.
Was it Kozlov?
Yeah, it was
Kozlov
expanding the battle
Kozlov is a dick,
boxes.
By the way. Yes. I'm not a fan of Kozlov. I'm not a fan of fighting against Kozlov, I should say. He's really good.
Who's worse, Kozlov or Tanith?
Well, I hate you, so... So I'm going to go with Tanith on that one. But no, Kozlov... it was too easy, man. Too easy.
Yeah, that was...
Anyway, so Tanith is a dirty, dirty bitch. I haven't played against her. So I honestly don't know. But looking at the rules on her card and going from there, she's...
If you make it to the journeyman now, you aren't going to play against her anyways.
Well, I figured that, but
I switched
honestly,
to Wormwood, so you're going to hate me more.
No. Wormwood's kind of a dick. It's okay.
Kind of. They almost doubled his feet area.
Yeah, Wormwood got way better. He's super good. But Tanith, just a quick glance over her rules. She seems super good. I haven't played against her, so I don't know the pain yet. I'm sure it's horrifying. But I have played against Kozlov, and he is a dick. He's a weapon master. He makes all of his jacks fast, which the only weakness Kator has is slow jacks, and now he makes the jacks fast. So, I mean, honestly, it's the Pathfinder no knockdown spell. The upkeep spell.
Oh, yes. Chosen Ground.
Chosen Ground. It's, I mean, I brought, what was I playing? I remember what I was playing. Yeah. So I was playing against Kozlov. I think I must have been playing Legion, but I had something to knock shit down, and it just wasn't working because he had Chosen Ground. So I'm like, oh, I'm going to hide behind a wall. Oh, no, he's got Pathfinder. Oh, I'm going to knock stuff down. Oh, no, he's got Chosen Ground. He gets no knockdown.
Yeah.
So Kozlov is a bastard.
Yeah.
But I haven't played against Tanith. I'm sure she's a dirty bitch, too.
She is.
Look, I hit you. It's a 4-inch AoE of Crippling Grasp. Oh, now you're all dead. Ha, ha, ha.
Yeah. Oh, you put a unit clump together? Sweet.
It's goddamn awful. So, yeah. And it's not a spell. It just happens.
It's a gun.
Yeah, no, it just happens. So you can't. Yeah. You can't. There's no
real
easy way.
Happens on direct hit. So you have to. You do have to direct hit. But yeah, exactly.
But she's rat 6 and she's boostable. So yep. I mean, yeah, no, it's bad.
And with the Wild Argus Animus, lols.
What's the Wild Argus Animus?
Living and undead automatically become defense 5.
If Ugh. Fuck you, Privateer Press.
Wow.
I mean, I still love you guys, but seriously, Tanith, what the fuck are you? What the hell were you thinking? She's good.
She's good.
No, she's really good. I haven't played against her, so I don't have an actual judgment on that, just based on card stuff. And what I've got available to me, she's really good.
All right, I think that's enough derailing. I think we can call
this one. I think that's a lot of derailing.
Yep. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Please like, comment, subscribe. If you have any requests, send them out. We'll do our best to make them. Have a good one.
Have a good night, guys. Thank you.
And we all check our phones.
You two check your phones.
Yeah.
Yep.